I screamed at the waves as they rushed away from me. The waves peaked and crashed. They screamed blasts of mist at me. I was 26, and I'd just broken up with Carol. Carol was my wife of 5 years. We'd married early, we'd married young, we'd married stupid. Sometimes, relationships just aren't what you think they are. Sometimes, relationships are like the crashing waves of the open sea. They swell, they crest, and then they rapidly descend into a sea filled with plenty of other fish. I knew I'd never see Carol again on that night in Hawaii. My beach home was a dark and lonely place. It was a time in my life when I needed a guide. I needed a sonar. In Echo the Dolphin, sonar is accomplished by pressing the square button on your PlayStation 2 DualShock controller. The dolphin makes noises and shoots a visible sine wave out of its nose. It's not clear whether other marine creatures are aware of the sine wave. Is it just a video game interface? A sine wave cannot hurt other creatures. It simply gets their attention. A sine wave is an abstraction. The sine wave is not real. This is a feature built out of necessity for video game functions in a video game universe. Inside of a video game, on your PlayStation 2 entertainment system, in a strange bit of irony, Echo the Dolphin represents everything that sine wave isn't. Echo the Dolphin is the world's greatest dolphin simulator. Echo the Dolphin has a story. It's a wild story. The story is, in fact, so wild that it becomes an abstraction as well. Do you really want to listen to the story? The designers ask. It's a calm proposition. You don't need to listen to it. You continue playing. Of course, you'll listen to the story. It's there for you to enjoy, right? You continue still. What's wrong with this story? There's aliens. There's dolphins. The game's plot becomes a feeble dreamscape of surreal banality. At this point, it becomes clear to you that the game's plot is actually genius. The game's plot is so impossibly strange that you begin to question yourself. Why do I care about this plot? Why does this game exist? You probe this question until you begin to approach it differently. Do I care? Why am I playing this game in the first place? Until finally you reach, why do I play video games? The narrative in Echo the Dolphin is simply a shell of a larger narrative, one that has been going on since the dawn of time. The meta nature presses the player to ask themselves if they are prepared to invest and indulge in the game's aforementioned surreal banality. Echo the Dolphin is a game where you can swim to the surface of the water and begin making dolphin calls. There's no reason for this. It simply exists because you can. Echo the Dolphin is a game where you can press select to spawn a compass in the corner of the screen. It does not guide you. It does not aid you. It simply exists because it is. In Echo the Dolphin, you can use your sonar on a shark, and the shark will eat you. you will die. There is no escaping this death. It simply exists because it must. There is also no escape from sharks that hide just outside the reach of the screen. The sharks are always present. They are never seen, but will attack and kill you at random intervals. When the sharks attack you, you will die. This is not a game like other games, where escaping death is the key to victory. Echo the Dolphin is a game about death. Echo is a dolphin, and dolphins are mammals. Echo the Dolphin is constantly dying. There is no way to stop Echo's impending death. Echo the Dolphin is a game about being underwater all the time and having an oxygen meter that never stops decreasing. Echo the Dolphin is about the inevitability of death. You are eventually going to drown if the sharks don't kill you first. In Echo the Dolphin, you can jump outside of the water for a brief second, which initially appears to be sedate respite from death's oncoming freight train. As it charges forward, you can close your eyes to the train and jump out of the water. You feel free. You feel as if the weight of death has been lifted off of your shoulders. You feel invincible. But as you plummet back into the water and open your eyes, you see that the train is not only still there, but now coming closer than ever. Occasionally, in Echo the Dolphin, you will be made to race other marine animals. They claim to be your friends, but will never help Echo unless Echo will first race them. Such we take as a comment on society's hypocrisy and worship of the modern rat race. Will these other dolphins do you a favor? Certainly. Are they your friends? Without a doubt. But only if you beat them first in a race. Those already ahead win favors. Really, there isn't a point to Echo the Dolphin. But at the same time, like most great works of art, Echo the Dolphin is a crystal clear ocean mirror in which our society reflects and sees itself. Echo the Dolphin does not make a statement, but merely echoes statements we've been making this whole time, and have never bothered to listen to. Echo the Dolphin is a game where you can clip into a wall and slowly asphyxiate a dolphin to death. It's not a sign, it's a signal.